JFD, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for December the 18th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against the majority of the other digital currencies on Thursday and during the Asian session Friday. It underperformed only versus SEK, NOK and the euro in that order, while it gained the most ground against the Canadian dollar, the British pound and the New Zealand dollar. The relative strength of the US dollar combined with the weakening of the commodity-linked loonie and kiwi suggests that the markets turned risk off at some point. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that although the majority of EU and US indices traded in positive waters, most Asian indices were in the red today. Japan's Nikkei 225, China's Shanghai Composite and Hong Kong's Hang Seng all slid 0.16, 0.29 and 0.88% respectively. Thursday was marked by increasing risk appetite as some European nations said that they were set to begin vaccinating their citizens with the Pfizer-BioNTech drug in the last week of December instead of the beginning of the new year as was earlier expected. The vaccine is expected to be approved by the European Medicines Agency during that week. On top of that, headlines suggested that in the US, top Republicans and Democrats got closer in agreeing on a new coronavirus aid bill, with an expected rise in initial jobless claims making the case even more imminent. That said, risk appetite softened heading into the Asian session today, perhaps on reports that negotiators in the US were struggling to agree on the details of a $900 billion coronavirus aid package. Comments from UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson that no trade accord would be reached unless the EU changes its position substantially may have also hurt sentiment. Now, despite the softening of investors' optimism during the Asian session today, we stick to our guns that the path of least resistance for equities is to the upside. Lawmakers from both major US political parties said that failing to agree on a COVID relief package is not an option, while Republican Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell said that talks could spill into the weekend. In our view, this suggests that a bill is more likely than not to pass before the end of the year. On the Brexit front, Irish Deputy Prime Minister Leo Varadkar said that he remains optimistic that the EU and the UK would secure a trade deal in the coming days, keeping hopes on that front on the table. So taking also into account that the vaccinations in Europe are likely to start earlier than previously anticipated, we see the case for equities and other risk-linked assets to rebound soon, while safe havens are likely to come under renewed selling interest. Now, in the FX world, the British pound was among the main losers, coming under selling interest following the pessimistic remarks by UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson. However, as we already noted, we think that there are still hopes for a trade agreement before year-end, hopes that may allow the British currency to rebound again. More headlines that the two sides are getting closer into sealing a deal are likely to benefit the pound, even against the Aussie and Kiwi, which are expected to perform well in a risk-on environment. For the pound to drift lower, we may need to get more headlines suggesting that a no-deal Brexit is the most likely outcome. Yesterday, we also had the SNB and Bank of England monetary policy decisions, while today in Asia, we had the Bank of Japan. Kicking off with the SNB, the bank kept its policy unchanged, reiterating that the Swiss franc remains highly valued and that they will remain active in the FX market as necessary. Then Bank of England stood pat as well, noting that quarter four GDP is likely to be a little weaker than expected in November, and repeating that it stands ready to increase its QE purchases pace should market functioning worsens. The Bank of Japan also announced no changes to its major settings, but extended its funding support program to firms that was introduced earlier this year in response to the coronavirus pandemic. Other than that, there was no other significant change. So in terms of market reaction, all three decisions passed largely unnoticed by the financial world. Now, as for today's events, during the early European session, we already got the UK retail sales for November, with both the headline and core sales falling by less than anticipated. The German IFO survey for December is also due to be released. The current assessment index is expected to have declined to 89 from 90, while the business expectations one is forecast to have risen to 92.5 from 91.5. This is likely to take the business climate index slightly lower to 90 from 90.7. Later in the day, we get more retail sales data, this time from Canada and for the month of October. Both the headline and core rates are expected to have declined to 0.2% month over month from 1.1% and 1% respectively. We also have three speakers on today's agenda, and those are ECB Supervisory Board Chief Andrea Enria, Chicago Fed President Charles Evans, and Fed Board Governor Lyle Brainard. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the Weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. At this point, I have to let you know that there will be no weekly market outlook webinar on Monday, neither a daily market review for the rest of the week. So goodbye, have a great day and greater week, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again on Monday the 28th.
JFT, just fair and direct.